straight a highway, a path for the Lord. Jesus is coming soon. Call back the sinners, wake up the saints, let every nation shout of your fame. Jesus is coming. Thank you.
You're sovereign. You're all powerful God, you're Yahweh. Oh God, you're the Lord that provides for us. You're the miracle maker, you're the way maker, you're the good shepherd. You're the one, oh God, that comforts us. You're the one with us 24/7. Oh God, you'll never leave us. Your love will never be unfailing for us. You'll never abandon us. Always there at the midnight hour. You be there, oh God, your mind is never busy for us. I believe and I know, God, I'm convicted that every time we pray, you hear our prayers. And we pray now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Silver and gold, I say, I have none. But what we give to everyone who have a COVID connection is the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we praise you for those hearers who are providing. For those folks in ICU who are sick. Oh God, we pray, oh God, for doctors. We pray, oh God, for the CDC and the World Health Organization. The universities, oh God, the pharmaceutical departments. We pray, oh God, for our environmental services, or EMTs, or public officials. Or law enforcement officers, God, because they're in the forefront of it all. But oh God Almighty, we cry out to you, Son of David, have mercy upon us. Yes. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hear our prayers, oh God Almighty. We, oh God, is so uncomfortable at times like these. But we know you're totally in control. We ask you, God, for your blessing now. Yes, Lord. We leave everything in your hand. Because you're perfect and you're a merciful God. And let the church say amen. Amen and amen. Can we give him praise? He's worthy of all praise. Thank you for being here, family. Please be seated. You won't have to worry about my landing if it's a foggy day. I will be landing. I've learned that not the length of the service that matters. Is about what the members of the church receive, the word.
Right. Amen.
I want us to be joyous today. I want us to praise him like you have never praised him before.
Yes.
Can we do that? Can we do that? Amen. I don't want my daughters to drop. I don't want my daughters to drop. And I got my son over there and keep going. I know we're going to have a good service today. Anyone believe that? We're going to smile. We're going to have joy. Please, can I share a secret with you? Don't let anyone know. Even the pastor's board, if we just could applaud the Most High God for me, please. Don't worry about what the pastor's saying. There's every pastor who's honest will tell you that some of the services that we preach, not even us would buy our own CD. We look back and say, oh God, I wonder if anybody got saved. Because we're only human, only His perfect. But you know, anything that we do to enhance and uplift God's kingdom, there is no failure in His book in the name of Jesus Christ. Failure. Human might say, I failed. But when God knows you're on a mission to make Him seen by someone who doesn't know Jesus Christ, you're a great success in His eyes. Anyone believe that? But today the sermon say, you can run, but you can't hide. Anyone remember that one? One moment, you can run, but you can't hide. There's some people who are still running away from Jesus. They're still straying away like a prodigal son. But does God know where they are? Yes, He does. You can run, but you can't hide. And I'm looking at the book of Jonah. I've preached this before and I said, I love it. Just to bring out a few things today. I want us to believe something very strange. And it says like this. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change, and the courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Can we give God praise for that? There's some things we're not going to be able to change. We're going through this coronavirus. We're going through this pandemic. And I'm positive now, if someone else could make that change, we would do it, wouldn't we? Yes. But we have got to understand there's some things that needs to be left by Almighty God, because He knows an answer for everything. Anyone understand what I'm saying? I want us to understand, none of us like to be powerless. Not one person in this church likes to be powerless. But the only time we'll have recovery is when we are powerless. The only time we will go to God is when we are weak. But He is strong. God is a powerful God. It was in this darkness, this helplessness, that Jonah, remember, there's a God. God sent Jonah to preach to the Ninevites. But because the Ninevites are godless, bloodthirsty people, Jonah said, Lord, I'm not going. Wow, boy, that takes something. Jonah, you have to understand, is a prophet. And he is not getting with God's program. Are we hearing what we say, church? Jonah is a man of God. He's like a pastor. And God gave him a job to do, and he deliberately said, indirectly, I'm not going. Let me tell you, you can run, but you can't hide. Because when God needed to do something for him, there's no way you can hide under a stone in the name of Jesus Christ. Isaiah said it best in chapter 6, verse 8. He says, send me, Lord. Send me on this mission. But Jonah says, I'm not going. I'm not going because these people that I'm going to preach to are evil people. These are our enemies to the children of Israel. Could you imagine God looking at people who are not doing His will, and He sent out a prophet to go to that country and say, go preach among these people to get repentance? And he said, no, I think I'm going to take a cruise. I can you imagine somebody telling the Lord saying, you're on a job, Pastor Malcolm, you need to get this done. And I say, I'm sorry, Sir Malcolm and I, we're going on a Royal Caribbean cruise. I guess we can't do it now with the pandemic in the name of Jesus. Where we have to cruise now is an old tub. You know, you pull the tub. He just as bad as Pastor. Pull the tub up, pull the plug, and fight the current in the name of Jesus Christ. But Jonah's not my God. These are evil people. They have attacked us. They have robbed us. And Lord, you're sending me to go and preach for those people. He said, Lord, I don't need to go. Just destroy them. What Jonah was saying. No, I'm not going, Lord. They deserve to be punished for all the things they did to us. And you are sending me. And I said, no, I'll just take a boat and I'll go in the opposite direction of where that place is. Thousands of miles, Jonah decides that's where he's going to go. You know, sometimes we have to examine ourselves. Sometimes we have to give ourselves a checkup from the neck up. Sometimes we're being called to do certain things that might be against our culture. But I want to say today that God wants to get our attention. That the people who have hurt our feelings, they are people that have hurt us so bad. That's why Jonah found that all is in our heart is vengeance. I know we're good Christians. Nobody has vengeance in their heart for anybody. Good Christian. But there are times in our own humanity. God understands what Jonah was going through. God understands when someone hurts you and abuses you. Deliberately and indirectly. And there's a saying in the Caribbean, they do it barefaced. Right in your face. There are times when you help people to go against you. And Jonah was struggling with this. He had a Jonah complex. But let me say today, declare it. That regardless of someone's culture, regardless of a person's ethnicity, regardless of a person's religion or nationality, regardless of someone who is rich or poor, God wants everyone to have salvation in the name of Jesus Christ. Everyone. Salvation for all. Many of us need to get on not a boat that's going the opposite way like Jonah. We need to get on the right boat that is marked salvation for all in the name of Jesus Christ. We need to board that bus and go on that cruise. What tonight, today's lesson is to understand that every person on God's earth that you have created will be hurt. Sometimes some of the closest people are the ones that do wrong to you. Sometimes these are the people that you care for who turn against you. The hands that say that feed that person, they'll turn around and bite those hands. I saw a sign on there, I might as well just say it. I saw a bumper sticking on those bumpers and something. This was very popular years ago. The person said, the more I meet people, the more I love my dog. So what he's saying, a dog, no matter what you do, he'll still wag his tail. And he has no soul, so he won't cry. Dog has no soul, so he won't cry. He'll just come up and just love you all over and lick up. I think God is telling us today in this pandemic and in this worry that we're going through. It's a time to reach out and touch someone in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Reach out to someone. Amen. Jonah had to learn the lesson of her scriptural way. So Jonah went on this boat to escape doing God's work. On this statement, may I say something to us? When we are powerless, God will lift us with his powerful hands out of all situations we're in. And we need God no more than any time. Jonah cried out to God, but God had to get his attention. Because he went on this boat. And the man went on this boat, he felt so good. He went to sleep. While there's a storm, Jonah went in the bottom of the boat to take a nap. No, he wasn't napping, he was snoring. The other godless, these pagan soldiers, sailors, prayed to their pagan god to stop the storm. Why is the storm happening? And nothing happened. The storm still roared. They said, wait a minute, there was a man who came on this boat. Let's go to him, because if we're praying to our gods, they worship idols now, we're praying to our gods and nothing happens. We need to find out what god this guy served downstairs and find out who is the cause of this storm. Jonah said, I'm the one, I'm the guilty party. I am the guy. At least he's doing something right. Then the guy said, listen, pray to your God to stop this storm, because our God can't stop this storm. I want to let you know that our God and Jonah, God is in the eye of every storm and every situation and every pandemic. But Jonah didn't even do that. Jonah was still mad to go on an assignment that he didn't want to go on, to go and forgive these godless, thirsty enemies. Was still in his heart. He said, throw me overboard. Jonah prefers death to doing God's work. A man of God. Where's his pride for God? See, I prefer to die. Throw me overboard. But as he was thrown overboard, church, the storm stopped in that ship. Instead of death, our merciful God had a great fish to swallow. Jonah. While Jonah was in that belly of that fish over 3 days, he came to his senses. He cried out and he says, I cried out to the Lord in my great trouble, and he answered me and called to you from the land of the dead, and Lord, you heard me. Our God will hear us even in the land of the dead in the name of Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter what situation and what mourning you're going through, our God sees everything, hears everything. But remember what God, what Jonah remembers, he began to what? To pray. God has to get our attention sometime. When we got to a bottom rock. Sometimes God can only get our attention when we're a broke one. God will always get our attention. God has compassion with us. He's merciful with us. He's merciful for us the same way he's merciful to Jonah. It's the same way we don't understand why God reigns on the just and the unjust. Because a merciful God, he warned these bloodthirsty enemies of his own people to have an opportunity for revival, for repentance, for deliverance. God is very patient with us. Very, very patient with us. Sometimes we have to remember that the person who have done us wrong person will come against us and hurt us, that our God still want them to repent and give them a chance to have salvation in the name of Jesus Christ. And it's our job and responsibility to bring it here. Oh yes, it's natural. It's very natural in all humanity to want God to punish them. Forgiving someone doesn't mean you condone their behavior. Forgiving someone doesn't mean you agree with their wickedness. What you're doing is giving them an opportunity to find Jesus to cleanse them in the name of Jesus Christ. Here's my cleansing. God wants everyone to have a chance to be saved. Every person. Even the person, a wicked murderer, God wants that person to have a chance to get their life changed. Will they ever still be punished? Yes. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. You don't worry about how to be punished. God will punish every wrongdoers in the name of Christ. But it's our responsibility to set our minds free. Because this is it. When we have vengeance in our heart, I want us to really listen to this, please. But this is a teaching, preaching moment. For many of us, including myself, go through the struggle of forgiveness. Like I said, when someone deliberately stabbed you in the back, someone hurt you, someone who you helped in their triumph of, oh goodness, don't go to your pastor. Time of financial problem and struggle. And you help them and they will turn against you. So it's natural that you don't want to forgive those people. It's natural that you feel revenge and hatred. But our Lord God Almighty is saying, as our pastor Jonah did this, why he brought Jonah back out of the pit. Jonah has a suicidal mind. That's how much vengeance he has in half of these wicked Ninevites. Done some wicked stuff to him and his family. This is the best example. But God would not let him escape on the ship. He wanted to get his attention to show how merciful and kind and just is our God. Do you know what I'm talking about, Jehovah God? Oh, just he is. Listen, Pastor, how do I do this when I'm hurt and abused? When we feel like revenge, when we have vengeance in our heart, when we are angry about what people have done us, it messes up our own reputation and messes up our own character. When we have something against someone like hatred and revenge, you're drinking their poison. And I've always said, while you're worrying about how they behave, they might be in the mall shopping and having a good time. And you're suffering with how much you're against them. God wants us to remember that it's human to make mistakes, but it's divine to forgive in the name of Jesus Christ. It's divine to forgive. Every human will make mistakes, make errors, but it's divine to forgive. Jonah didn't want to, but God got him caught in a big fish. What's amazing, the fish brought him, that's a cruise line. The ship brought him, the fish, brought him right on the shore and spit him out. At Nineveh. Nineveh is the capital of Assyria. Nineveh is a small city to this day in Iraq. It's there to this day. God brought him. He didn't want to come. But God brought him to preach. He had to go and tell them of the impending destruction if they don't change. Jonah must have preached the worst sermon in his entire life. I can see Jonah went there and he didn't even have an on-off service. Jonah didn't even take a praise and worship team. Jonah just probably went and said, okay, if you all perish, you all perish. I just said, Jonah, just think about it. Jonah probably, the worst sermon he was have preached that day. Because even when he was there, he was still what? Angry and upset how God wanted not to destroy these people. But he said the word, I'm sure he must have been so negative. But even with your negativity, God can transform that into positivity in the name of Jesus Christ. See, God doesn't call the qualified. I'm going to say that slowly. God doesn't call those that said, I got my degrees, I'm a professor and all that. He doesn't call those people. He said, God called people that he chooses and he uses. He's not worrying about your abilities. He's only worried about your availabilities in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you available? He qualifies those who he called. And he must have made Jonah negative sermon so positive that everyone in Nineveh began to fast, began to pray. Even the animals were fasting, so no food for your animals. We are fasting. We're going to go into a revival, and we're going to give our life to Jesus Christ so we understand how much it can happen. Need our responsibility of forgiving someone the way the Lord forgives us will help that person also give their life to Jesus Christ. It's an encouragement. But when we're disobedient, disobedience doesn't just affect us. It affects our entire family. Amen. When we do wrong, it's not just us that are being punished. Other members of the families and friends are suffering the same consequences. You heard about families and then dragging it on in place you didn't want to go. Because of your love for them. That's what Jonah did to the guys on the ship. They suffered the storm because he was disobedient to God. God is calling us in this pandemic, in this time of the COVID-19, God is calling us to practice the fruit of the Spirit. Very difficult, but God wants us to have joy. God wants us to show happiness. God wants us to show goodness, gentleness, generosity, kindness. God wants us to be faithful to him. And he wants us to control our tongue in what we do in life today. God wants us to show more love than we ever shown it before. He's crying out to us. But here's what happened after Jonah made that sermon. With his bitterness against the people. Would you believe what happened with that sermon after they fasted? There's 120,000 people in Nineveh. They all 120 repented in the name of Jesus Christ and became the children of God. To know awesome God. When folks have hurt us, it's not easy to forgive them. When folks have deliberately wronged us, it's not easy to forgive them. Especially when you know what God done. The scriptures say, don't let the sun go down and be angry. Forgiveness is powerful. Forgiveness shows your growth as a believer in Jesus Christ. It doesn't mean that person necessarily going to be a friend again. Let me say that very carefully. Okay, if you told someone your secret and they put it on Facebook and every book that is on there in the handbook, wherever the book they got, and they tell everyone your business out there, you're confining them. You forgive them, but you never give them your secret again. Forgiveness doesn't mean you go and sleep with that person again. They have to buy back that trust. Forgiveness doesn't mean someone came to you and you helped them financially and they never kept their promise. Well, you'd be a fool to give them again. But you say, I forgive you. Let God deal with that situation. So when someone has done you wrong, you clean. Forgiveness is for us, yourself. If you know that if you call the person that says, I forgive you, it's going to be another war. Just go to the Lord and pray, Lord, I forgive that person in the name of Jesus. How do you know that person is a warrior? They would have to go into two belly of fishes for you to get with them again. You know the people you're dealing with. What you're doing is freeing yourself. And say, Lord Almighty God, can we do that right now? Can we do that? I forgive them in the name of Jesus Christ. Give God praise. Just forgive them. I got folks too. I'm live on television. I can't tell everybody who I got. That I have to forgive as well. We have to learn forgiveness, what God did, what God got Jonah's attention when in the belly of a fish. Sometimes God has to hit us to the bottom for us to come to our senses. Sometimes God has to show us another way. His way, His program. We are powerless without God's program. Anyone understand what I'm saying? We are powerless. God's program is perfect. God wants us to reach out to people. Because by us showing a difference of walking the right walk, that person probably will turn around. Sometimes we don't want God to forgive them, we want God to punish them. But remember, if we can look in our rear view mirror and give a testimony, how great is our God, it probably helped that person that needs the name of Jesus Christ. Anyone know what I'm saying? Has anyone here been blessed? Has anyone been a blessing to talk about? In this time of the pandemic, we have to understand that God will give us the vision to see the things we can't deal with, but give us the courage to deal with what we have to deal with. The courage to wear masks when we're uncomfortable. The courage to wash our hands more than we ever washed our hands before. I look at my hands the last time and say, boy, this hand is too clean. Wash after wash. Sometimes I think my skin is going to rub off. But God is merciful. Do we need to have a Jonah spirit today? Or the spirit of God? I just want to say to you today that it's not easy. That is to get rid of bitterness for those who have hurt us. It's not easy. But God's remedy is the best. Same way He forgave us of our sins, we should forgive others in the same sense. And again, it doesn't mean you're going to have the same relationship with that person. But you're freeing yourself of that load. Are we prepared to be obedient to God? I've always shared this story with you. And I'm going to read it and I'm going to ask you a question as we close. A little girl was talking to her teacher about whales. The teacher said it was physically impossible for a whale to swallow a human because even though it was a very large mammal, its throat was very small. The little girl stated that Jonah was swallowed by a whale. Irritated, the teacher reiterated that a whale could not swallow and human. It was physically impossible. The little girl said, when I get to heaven, I will ask Jonah when I go to heaven. The teacher asked, what if Jonah went to hell? The little girl replied, then you ask him. Do you want to ask Jonah? May I ask you? Do you want to meet Jonah and ask him about that encounter in the belly of a whale? The only way we're able to meet Jonah and ask him the question and speak with him to tell him this story is that we know Jesus Christ as our personal Savior. Hallelujah. Are we prepared for that? Are we going to be prepared to be there in heaven? Are we going to be prepared to be there? That's our responsibility. To be in the right place at the right time. God will always fight for us. But we must learn to be obedient to His word. We must learn that God is a merciful God. This is why I'm praying for good Christians who have the COVID. This is why pastors have even died during this pandemic. Because God is a just God. He has a reason for everything. He's beyond all understanding. There's no immunity that someone's going to have and say, I would never get COVID. What we're responsible to do is doing the right thing. As this time goes on, don't you realize that there are some things we're not going to be able to change right now? But we just have to go with God's program. I believe from the bottom of my heart that if God could bring the children of Israel out of Egypt, 10 plagues. And the last one, he says, put the blood of the Lamb over your doors. I think we have the blood of Jesus Christ of our body, and we're going to get through this as well. It's the same God. Same God that we serve. It's the same God that had his son Jesus Christ that raised Lazarus from the dead. It's the same God that had his son raise Jairus' daughter. Same God that had one more, 3 miracles of dead people that Jesus did in his 3 years ministry. The woman from Nain, when her son was in that casket, going by the cemetery, and God raised that child from the dead. It's the same God that opened the eyes of the blind. I think it's the same God we have today that at his own time in coronavirus, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus Christ. The same God that we have. We must trust him. Will you stand with me? We must trust him. It's the same God we have to trust today. As we said in all Wednesday night service, that before I pray, we as children of God must read the Bible. We can't be going no opposite direction like Jonah. That's right. God has a program for us which is perfect. And during this time when we feel powerless, we need to get all power from Almighty God. Amen. Please, as believers, don't listen to everything you hear out there. And this pandemic, everyone's an expert. It's like when we all had a common cold, you remember? Someone to tell it to go and boil some bush tea. Someone say get mint tea. Someone say drink some coffee. Everyone give an example. Everyone trying to help. Today, everyone across the globe is all different version. I think we need to read Matthew chapter 24, verse 1 to 51 to let you know that no one knows what's going to happen but Almighty God. Who believe that? We have got to stop listening to the naysayers. Or else you're going to be like a yo-yo going around and around and coming back in the same circle. I want us all across the globe to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not in your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct where we are going in Jesus' name. Can we give Him praise? Let us pray. Father, we know there are many believers in your sanctuary today. We know, God, we just had 9 candidates who are baptized to show publicly that you're Lord of their life now. But oh God Almighty, there's just one person in the sanctuary today. Just one person who are watching through electronic streaming. I pray, oh God, that they will find the church and they will get involved there to give their life to Jesus Christ. I pray, oh God, that it takes each one reachable. I forget, oh God, that we'll continue to bear your strength to forgive those that does not deserve forgiveness. But oh God, you prove it with Jonah. You prove it, oh God, that when you want people to repent, when you want someone to come your way, they can run, but they can't hide away from you. The Apostle Paul, who wrote 13 books, 13 epistles, his name was one Saul. He persecuted the Christian. Then one day, oh God, you got him on Damascus Road. His revival began and he became a great man of God. Father, we must learn to forgive each other. And we are going to ask you for your help. Because it's so difficult at times to forgive those who hurt us. But oh God, we have to set an example because that's what you want us to do. Oh God, let us understand that you could use Jonah, who didn't want to preach a sermon. But by preaching, you converted, oh God, 120 souls to know an awesome, majestic, sovereign God. Today, oh God, have your way. As we pray to remember very clearly, God grant us the serenity to accept the things that we cannot change and the courage to change what we're able to and the wisdom to know the difference. And let the church say amen and amen and amen. Can we give God praise? Praise his name.